Hey guys, so as you're probably all aware at this point, the Condition Ranger did suffer some pretty heavy nerfs in this recent balance patch. The main differences being the changes to the condition duration foods, as well as tiny changes to our pets which have made them far less effective in combat. Overall though, we're still fairly strong, and I think with a few changes we can still fit into a meta composition quite easily. The main thing that comes to mind is our ability to switch out Flame Trap for Sun Spirit, and we can pop that on cooldown. Pretty much is the same DPS overall, but it does mean our Condition Druid can then take Sharpening Stone, which ends up being about 2k DPS increase for the team. So in terms of the build itself, things have changed slightly. We're still going with full Viper armor, weapons, and trinkets. For your runes, you're going to want a full set of Krait runes, which boost your bleed duration by quite a lot. In terms of sigils, I've gone for Geomancy and Smouldering on Axe Torch, then Geomancy and Venom on Shortbow. I believe there's some discussion about Earth Sigils on both weapons, and I have tested that, however the results come back pretty much identical. However, with Earth Sigils, if there are any adds or, you know, additional targets nearby, then there's a huge chance that those extra bleeds are going to cleave onto those adds, and you'll end up with far less DPS on the boss itself. Whereas with the Smouldering and Venom, it pretty much boosts all of your damage by a flat amount, so even the cleave will go up. Swapping the pet on cooldown to trigger Poison Master actually breaks even right about now, however it just adds complexity to the rotation for no real benefit. For those who don't know, the pets are currently bugged in that any conditions they apply, so the bleeds from the Lynx F2 for example, use the pet's condition damage. However, when you switch pet, their condition damage is effectively set to zero because they don't exist anymore. The numbers also completely disconnect from the ranger themselves, so it's almost like somebody else is doing the damage, which gives the effect of golem numbers being a little underestimated. I'm pretty sure that when that bug is fixed, pet swapping is going to become a very interesting and fun mechanic to increase our damage.